Past couple of vlogs, Battletech, we were looking at what takes out light mechs, what takes out mediums, heavies, assaults, and we were continuing some review with a couple of mechs. We looked at the Victor, I believe yesterday or this morning, we looked at the Assassin on there, and I was asked, so I'm going to turn it over to you guys, absolute worst, worst mech that's out there. And we're going to open this up, Inner Sphere, no clans, just pure tonnage. What do you think is the worst mech that's out there? Now, I think we have to define this as a couple of a checklist here. And then I realize we're going to be beaten on somebody's favorite mech. And surprisingly, my vote for the worst mech or one of the worst mechs, top five worst mechs, is one of my favorite mechs. And I routinely like to play it. But I play it mad, knowing the deficiencies. And I play it for the lulls, purely for the lulls factor on the table. If I'm being a little more tactical or I'm trying to be a little more competitive, it does not make it to the table. So the checklist for me would be, this is a mech. It has to be a mech that has a defined role, but just does not do it well. Almost like you're looking at the tech manual, you're looking at the sales brochure, and you're like, are we talking about the same mech? Second, it has to be over budget in terms of battle value or C-bills. For whatever reason, the role that it's assigned to, it's a lot of cash. It's a lot of currency on there. We can do something else mech-wise equally or better on there. And quirks. Within that role, just things that don't match whatsoever. Maybe it's mismatched weapon systems. Maybe it's some design feature that just does not work on there. When all these things come together, it creates a mech. Okay, in theory, it's better to have a mech than no mech. You don't want to be in the ranks of the dispossessed. But are you taken seriously on there? Would you be better off selling it for the C-bills, doing a little gambling, and getting yourself a real mech on there? Okay, for me, my vote, and the splash screen here is kind of giving it away a little bit because you know it's not the Archer. It would be the Charger. Do we really need an assault based recon mech with that much armor on there? And I should say we're looking at stock mechs. I should have started with that. We're looking at stock, not variants that correct the initial design flaws, because some of the variants for the Charger, they're not that bad on there. It turns into a semi-respectable assault mech, but that's not what it was designed for. So we have this assault mech that has good speed for an assault mech, but for a recon mech, a light mech is faster, as fast or a lot faster on there. Do you really need that much armor? Because if you're a light, if you're a recon mech, you're not sticking around. It's your speed and distance that's going to keep you safe. The weapon system is just a bunch of small lasers, which means you got to get really close to engage if you have to on there. At least if you're going to make a crazy recon mech, give it some bite, give it some punch, especially if it's an assault class mech. Give it some bite, give it some punch, so if it has to fight, it can bring that massive tonnage with weapon systems to bear. PPC, maybe something like the Banshee. Banshee's almost a better recon mech on there. It's undergunned for, and I like the Banshee. It's a solid, solid design. But for an assault class mech, it is a little bit undergunned. But if we took that weapon system and put it on a recon mech, heavier recon mech, assault recon mech, that's got some bite. You're not going to send that Locust or Jenner to intercept the recon mech. So, but we have small lasers on there, and they're all over the place. I guess you can punch. I guess you can kick, and you can charge, and you can body slam. C-bills. For an assault mech, it comes in pretty cheap. Yeah, because all the cash for the weaponry is spent elsewhere on there. Better off spending the C-bills on a dedicated light mech or a dedicated recon medium mech. That's just my opinion. On a side note, I do like this mech for the lulls. I like spending a turn or two running up the side of the map, running up at the back of the map. I don't have to worry about getting hit or crippled with a shot, obviously, if it's a headshot or a critical engine hit, that's going to happen to any weight class, but I don't have to worry about my leg getting blown off on the way in. And I run in there, and I body slam you, and I punch you, and I charge you, and I kick you, and I do all that stuff completely for the lulz. No way I'm playing it like an assault recon mech on there. That would be my vote for one of the worst mechs. Your vote, worst mech, Inner Sphere, Battletech.